Welcome to Conquer New Markets Overseas webinar. My name is Levent Yıldızgören, and some short information about me. I have 28 years of industry experience, mentor, speaker, charity supporter. I also host a podcast called Conquering New Markets by Breaking Language Barrier. I'm a visiting lecturer at the University of Essex and also Prince 2 qualified. This is my podcast available in Apple Podcast as well as most popular platforms. Simply search for Conquer New Markets by Breaking Language Barriers. This is where I speak with many entrepreneurs who have successfully expanded to international markets, and they share their tips and experiences. The company that I'm a founder of is TTCV Translate. Has got 28 years of language services experience, one-stop service provider, and this is very customer focused, and we support United Nations global goals. Now, the points we will cover during this webinar is some of these are below, which includes UK's current state with global trade in the light of ending the transition period end of December. If there's no deal, what it will mean for UK exporters? What is the solution and tools to use for reaching a decision in regards to which country to target? And we'll talk about a do-it-yourself solution as well as do-it-with-you solution, which is, I'll mention it at the end of the webinar. Now, the current situation in the UK is that still the deal is not in place yet, and the deadline is very close. So it is a big uncertainty about this situation. And free trade deals, I'll mention it, how many of these we have completed so far, but there is we haven't completed all the existing free trade deals. On top of this, global growth is slowing due to the pandemic, and UK growth is predicted to be the slowest for the last 10 years. So all of these makes entrepreneurs, business owners, marketing directors' job even more critical, because in order to make 2021 a success, I think we all have to take assertive action. Now, if your company is heavily exporting to EU countries, the VAT situation, because it's not clear who's going to charge VAT, who's going to be responsible, are we going to be able to claim it back, must be giving you a lot of sleepless nights, because, you know, overnight you can be 20% more expensive if you can't, for instance, claim the VAT back. What about tariffs or quotas? Are, you know, there's no clarity about this. Export duty is not clear yet. And so that makes it bit difficult. And here I wanted to mention about what's a free trade deal, because we keep hearing this a lot. Basically, a free trade deal is signed between two countries. It is intended to make trading easier and simpler. It reduces or eliminates tariffs and quotas, and also doesn't involve cross-border taxes. For instance, anything that we sell to European Union countries is considered to be a dispatch because of the free trade deal deals. But after, say, 1st of January, anything we sell to European Union countries will be treated as exports. So that's the kind of implication of having a free trade deal or not. Now, you may be wondering, you know, where does UK trade, who does the UK trade with? Interestingly, 49% of UK exports goes to EU countries. This is from the Department of International Trade, and these are 2018 statistics. I don't think it has changed a lot for the last 2 years. Rest of the world is 40%. 11 is the, because of the EU trade agreements. So the 11% plus 49 is the direct involvement with EU. Now, these are the top trading partners. This is again 2017, but I know I've checked some of the figures. There's little variations. For instance, the trade with Switzerland has gone up, but overall, I think it's a very similar picture. As you can see, US is the top trading partner, with exports being at least 30 billion pounds higher than the imports UK receives from United States. Now, at that point, it's important to see what is the internet users in the world. In the bottom half, the bottom blue is 49%, which is the, you know, the whole of Asia. So the when it comes to internet users in the world, the Europe is, and North America is only about a quarter of the whole internet users. That I thought that's interesting. Now, so the UK trade deals so far, you know, let's say let's look at the state of the UK trade deals. Now, existing UK has a 40 trade deals covering 70 countries because of the EU membership. So far, UK has signed 27 trade deals covering 57 countries. So there's still a difference of 23 countries that is in the pipeline being considered. Last deal was signed with Singapore for 10th of December, and Singapore happens to be one of the important trade partners for the UK. Now, you can see it here. These are the countries that has been rolled over from the UK trade, EU trade deal, at the Canada being the top, and of course there's quite a lot more countries, but I just wanted to put here the main ones. Sorry, I said Canada, but it's not Canada. It's Switzerland that has is the highest volume. Now, so in the light of all this turmoil in the you know, world economy, what's going on with pandemic and the end of the transition period. So, what is there to do for companies who heavily rely on EU or wants to go global? So, selling globally, is it good for you? Is it convenient for, or is it suitable for every single company? Obviously, it's a decision that you need to explore, really. You know, doing a due diligence is so important. But generally, the big prize when you manage to get into a new country market is that you depend less on your domestic market. And it is like having another channel to sell more of your service or your product. Also, often most companies, established companies, can come to a saturation point in their domestic market. So going globally can be the ideal time to increase sales and continue with growth. And of course, selling globally will increase your profits, and also it will open doors to go into other countries. Selling to a country, and there's someone who is close by to that country could be your ideal customer, because countries who live close by often share the same cultural traditions and similar purchasing habits. So if you're selling country A, who's in border with country B, it could well be your target audience as well. Okay, are there some barriers that can stop companies or company owners taking that global step? Often what we come across is that when the business owners or sales development people are too immersed in their product or their company, they may think that our product is so technical, we can't translate it or we can't communicate this in another language. And for the same sentiment, they say, well, if it isn't in English, it will never be understood. And also common belief that we come across is that, well, everybody understands English anyway, or selling globally is far too complicated. In regards to the last one, everybody understands English, is that that always is a result of expectation that customers will find us, so we don't need to find them. And this could be a bit of a barrier that can be on the way of companies' growth, because there are so many choices, so many options for customers, whether they are business customers or consumers, that, you know, we can't take it for granted that they'll find us. Of course, another worry is that by going into another country, companies may be worried that their product may be copied. So these are some of the beliefs that we come across that may be stopping companies growing globally. So some of the barriers, you know, is there no barriers? Of course there are barriers when you try to sell cross borders. Custom regulations, collecting payments, you know, different legal systems. What you're used to in your own country is not likely to be applicable in other countries. So different legal systems will pose problems or challenges. Delivery and collections. If there's a customer return, what do you do? You know, it is, these are various things. And of course, language and cultural barriers. It's important to take those on board. And of course, product and packaging modifications. It is very unlikely that the existing packaging will be accepted by another country, because some countries have different requirements for packaging, and if it is not respected, it may end up, you know, companies calling and product callbacks, which can be very expensive. So these are some of the barriers you may come across, and hopefully I'll be providing some tips and links for you, so that you can actually address these before going or before taking action, or you can look at this before reaching a decision about which country would be ideal for your product or service. So what are the deciding factors? Should you be going to country A or country B? And what is the best way to choose between those? And our motivation is really for companies, especially if they are relying heavily on EU countries for their revenues or growth, it is really important to look far afield and trying to see what alternatives are there. So let's have a look at some of the deciding factors. Now, the first one is really target countries' trade statistics and figures. So this could be an important factor. Language and customs. What sort of language and customs that exist in that country? Ease of doing business. And what are the keyword search volumes for your service or product? Market trends and Google Market Finder results. Because at the start, using those tools such as Google Market Finder can be beneficial to reach a decision. And of course, physical distance, especially if it's a physical product, then the distance can be important in regards to making deliveries or if there's a matter of collection. So what tools are there to address for each one? So let's have a look at the target country trade stats and figures. What's important is the basic information about the country. Time zone, you know, what time zone are there? And if you're new to exporting, a time zone that is minus 10 hours or plus 10 hours, then could be really difficult for you. So a time zone could be an important point. Of course, the how much trade is going on between this that country and the UK, because more trade there is, it is more likely to have support and support and facilities for your service or company service or product. The country's GDP per capita, higher it is better, because that means there's more money to be, there's more disposable income if you're selling to consumers, or there's more money in the business to spend for investment or new products. How many UK contacts on the ground? What I mean by that is, you know, is there a UK government representative in that country that you can call up, ask questions? I've heard so many entrepreneurs that they found this very useful, because they could call a contact in France, Germany, Turkey, or Switzerland, asking questions, and because of these contacts on the ground, it made their life so much easier. And what sort of, you know, who do they trade with? Is there any trading? Do they have any trading partner that UK is already partnering with? So this could be an important one as well. And that link is very good, trademap.org. You can find some of these information from that URL. The other one is language and customs. What is the language or languages spoken in that country? If you're thinking of Canada, and French is the second language in Canada, in Quebec, it is, well, their official languages are English and French. It's very important to be aware of that, because that could be a detrimental for packaging purposes or user manuals. Religion or religions, you know, which religion is it? That, because that's important for public holidays and cultural habits. Ethnicity. Some countries can have a different ethnical geography, and to be aware of that could be very important. Business etiquette, that could be very important, especially at the start of the relationship, because if you know the business etiquette, you can accommodate it much easier. For instance, in some countries, taking calls during a business meeting is not considered to be impolite. And if you know that, if you're aware of that, then when your business partner or the person you're trying to do business with takes a call during the meeting, you know that it's nothing personal. In some cultures, you know, the silence is important. You know, before a meeting, there could be like 20 seconds silence where everybody looks at each other, and, you know, if you're aware of this, then that 20 seconds won't feel like a lifetime. The number of internet users, especially if you're offering a digital product, you know, the number of internet users is very, very important in the data to be aware of. Social media culture. So if your advertising or brand awareness depends on social media, say for instance in the UK, you use social media a lot, you have followers, what is their social media culture? Is it a Facebook country? Is it an Instagram country? Or, you know, how much of these are used? So what is the influence of Facebook in those countries for consumers making decisions? Is your target audience in LinkedIn? How much of it is being used by the business community? For instance, in Germany, there are, in addition to LinkedIn, there are other platforms that a lot of business people can be found on. So it is important to be know what these are. Now, ease of doing business is very important, especially if you're selling goods or services via e-commerce. So the state of digital economy is very important. Internet infrastructure, existing e-commerce volumes. If you're an e-commerce company, checking the volumes is very important. If the volumes are very low, then maybe you need to think even more carefully before taking any step, because that could be that could give you some indications. Payment gateways. If your system is set to a certain payment gateway, do not assume that it will be in that country. So check out if that payment gateway is available there. If not, can you accommodate the existing ones? And what are the popular e-commerce platforms? We are aware of Amazon, Alibaba, eBay, but are these the eBay only eBay platforms in those in that country, or is there any other one that you need to be aware of? Of course, ease of doing business often connected with political stability. So what is the political stability in that country? In regards to ease of doing business, this is a very, very useful resource by World Bank, and they renew this, replenish this almost every year, and that's 2019, the current one. So you can actually see the ease of doing business, collecting payments, what is it like, red tape. So that gives you a lot of valuable information for that particular country. Of course, Department for International Trade provides markets information by going to this great.gov.uk. You can actually find a lot of information about the markets. And again, the World Bank data on countries. So you can simply go there and then search each country for a variety of statistical information. Now, the other one is keyword search volumes. Keyword search volumes always give you a good indication of how much demand is there for your product or service in that country. And what are the popular search engines? Do everyone use, you know, does the 98% of search carried out on Google, or are there other players, especially in Russia or Eastern Europe? You know, there are equally famous or equally used popular search engines, one of which is called Yandex, but there are more smaller ones in other countries. So it's important to be aware of what these are. Of course, the e-commerce volumes is also important, because, you know, once you know the keyword search volumes and you look at it in the light of e-commerce volumes, then you can sort of make a lot more sense about that. One second, I'm just, yeah, right. Okay. And Of course, search volumes for competitors. So that gives you an idea about what your competitors are doing for a similar product or an identical product as yours or service in that matter. And that gives you an idea about the potential of the market. And keyword research is what I mean by that is if your product is called, for instance, hanger, and it is a hanger for trousers, hanger for skirts, hanger for ties, you know, what keyword is used in the target country? It is often different. So it's not a direct translation. It is often different. And it is important to do that research to find exactly which keywords bring more research, have more search results for you. One example for service, for instance, customer experience is often referred to as CX in the UK. So CX solutions, CX experience, CX consultancy is very commonly used in the UK for customer experience. So if you do a search for CX experience for Spain, you'll get a very little result because CX, even though it is used by some, but the main search result comes when you use a translation of customer experience and do a search with that. And that applies to quite a few countries. So you shouldn't assume that what is the keyword that you use in the domestic market is likely to be the same in the target country. So it's important to do this research to establish what those keywords are, and often this could be useful for any content creation as well. Google has got a very good market trends website. So you can actually find out the trends in a given country for a given product. So this is a very useful tool. It is free, and you know, it just makes total sense to make use of that. And again, with Google Market Finder, you can actually enter your company website, enter your product, and Google will make suggestions for you. I mean, can you make a decision based on that? Bit difficult, but it'll give you some indications, because this will be in addition to what you've been searching, and together with that data, that could be a good quality information, you know, that can help you to get good quality information. This is very much like what we talked about, you know, the Market Finder trends, the data in World Bank and UK government, and there's plenty of it. Believe in me, there are plenty of resources that you can actually tap into to get information. This is very much like do-it-yourself information. Now, also, I'd like to talk to you about do-it-for-you solution. And then I'll mention what I mentioned in the beginning of the presentation. I want to talk to you about the product that we have. And so this is very much do-it-for-you solution. We have a product called New Country Testing Kit, and it very much does covers the areas that I've been mentioning. So basically, the most important one is to give you an idea about the potential in the target country that could be for your product or for your service. So what sort of potential is that? And what is the current demand? And so that you can actually plan accordingly. And the likely barriers that could, you know, prevent growth. So what are these? And anything you know in advance will help you to make that decision so much easier. And of course, the more the decision is informed, is more likely to to get you the result that you're looking for. And of course, it'll avoid unnecessary delays. And often delays are, you know, comes delays with costs. So it will avoid you having unnecessary delays or costs. So what you get in that new country testing kit product, there will be a one-to-one discovery meeting up to 90 minutes. This will be, it won't be face-to-face because of pandemic. It will be online. That's where we find out about your product, service, what is that you want to achieve. And following that, we will start our study, and then you'll get a customized report for the target country covering all this information. There will be a keyword research for the target country for your product or service, and there will be a summary report so that you can actually take this into account before taking that next step. So the content, you know, there will be a nicely laid out report giving you all this information. And of course, the you know, it'll include, for instance, payment methods. In certain countries, cash on delivery is not unusual. This is actually a report we did for a customer for Germany. And 90% of consumers, 9% of consumers prefer to pay cash on delivery. So it's important to be aware of this. And in the UK, mostly it is paid in advance before the delivery. And bank transfer is, yes, you can do a bank transfer, but I'm not sure it is a preferred method for most consumers. Now, this is again for Germany. Amazon is not the only marketplace. So there's auto.de, there's real.de. So this is it's an important information. If you are, you know, selling through e-commerce website, again, keyword research is very important because that can affect all your Google AdWords, that can affect your content creation, that can affect if you're creating a micro website or creating some landing pages. So knowing that keyword, right keywords, the whole copy can be adjusted accordingly. Translations is important, of course, but often translators are not aware of keyword restrictions. So it could be a perfectly good translation, but it may not be the highest one that brings a keyword research. So keyword research is very important. And in the report, you will get some information about the, you know, for each keyword bringing what sort of search results it brought in certain time period, so that you can actually make a decision based on that. Of course, summary, there will be a summary and recommendations report to help you to decide whether it is the country that's ideal for you. And if there's any names that you get translated or you intend to use that's not appropriate, we will also inform you about that. And the, you know, recommendations will include, you know, if you don't have any landing pages, we will make sure that we mention that to you. And you know, and it'll include like custom reviews and stuff like that. Now the usual price for that is $399 plus VAT, but for webinar participants, we have an offer of £199 plus VAT, and that is the on the condition that you make a you apply until 4 p.m. tomorrow. Now, these, just to summarize the benefits for you, you get the find out the potential in the target country, current demand, what are the likely barriers for growth, so that you can make informed decisions and avoid unnecessary delays and costs. So this is pretty much the webinar, what I intended to mention. This is a couple of testimonials from customers that we did. And of course, we have 100% money back guarantee. So if you're not satisfied with the report, we will fully refund you. We have terms and conditions for that, but generally we want you to be pleased with that. So there's 100% money back guarantee. Just to repeat, £199 plus VAT if you order until 4 p.m. tomorrow. So this is the email address. If you email info@ttcvtranslate.com, we will process that for you. Well, thank you very much for joining. I hope you found it useful. If you have any questions, please feel free to put it on the chat and I'll do my best to answer them. Please contact me at info@ttcvtranslate.com and have a great day.